Hello friends, today I'm starting this new tutorial series dedicated to creating cinematics with Unreal Engine 5, and I'm going to start with a pretty long introduction. This first series of maybe 5-6 episodes is going to be introductory. We are going to create these simple cinematics, and while doing this we are going to learn some basic but very important things about cinematics. And this first series is going to take a few weeks to be fully published, and maybe an hour or a few hours for you to follow all the episodes step by step. But I promise that after you complete it, it will take much less time for you to create simple scenes like this one. And after we complete this basic project, we'll gradually be moving to more advanced things, such as animating photoreal people in cinematic scenes. Friends, I'm going to do some things from scratch in this tutorial. I know it might be boring to those who already know some basics, but my personal opinion and advice, guys, don't skip these parts. I know we all people come into this industry possibly have an above average intelligence, and we hate doing boring things over and over again. Believe me or not, but when we force ourselves to repeat these boring routine things, our professionalism and overall understanding grows, as it improves and updates neural connections inside our brains. And it develops our power of will. And we gradually gain more and more mental power to dive into really complex things. You know, friends, I believe that in a few years we will see all the fashion industry migrating from real-world photo models and photo shoots to digital ones created within Unreal Engine. And we will have new supermodels which will look just like real people on photo and video. And when fashion magazines like Vogue will receive sets of high fashion photos submitted to them for publication, their editors will never be able to say for sure whether these are real photos or 3D renders. And clothing brands will stop paying millions of dollars to human models and photographers, and it will be a new era of digital content, and digital artists will occupy this fashion niche. We can already export clothing items from Marvelous Designer to Unreal Engine, and they look just like in real world. And I will later publish some tutorials on this topic as well. And this is why I am starting creating these tutorials. I'm going to split this first series to pretty short episodes. Each of them will be covering a specific step of creating this scene. And now, let's go straight ahead. Let's launch Unreal Engine 5. Select the third-person game template. Let's enable ray tracing. And let's name the project Cinematics Tutorial. Hit the Create button. So, the project has been created. We are going to create a new map for our cinematic purposes. Go to File, New Level, and select the Basic Preset. Hit the Create button. In this particular tutorial, we are going to learn lighting with HDRI backdrop. So, we select and delete all these actors. We can select them with the left mouse button holding Ctrl on our keyboard. And we then press the Delete button on our keyboard. Now, go to Edit, Plugins, and start typing HDRI. And enable the HDRI backdrop plugin. It requires restart, so just let it restart. It prompts us to save our newly created map, and we save it. It prompts us to name it. Let's name it Cinematic Man. Save it. Waiting for restart. Let's open our new map. Oh, it is so dark. We have deleted all of the lights, do you remember? And just for convenience, let's set our new map as a default one. So when we load the project, it loads in our editor. Go to Edit, Project Settings. Search for Default. And you see this editor startup map. Change it to our cinematic map. Let's also change the game default map. Not sure we need it, but just in case. Alright. And now we press this quick add button in the top bar. And under the lights, we can now find the HDRI backdrop option. Let's add it. Oh yeah, and it has been loaded with the default backdrop. We are going to change this to our dark and scary backdrop. There is a link in the description to download it from Polyheaven. There are two nuances. First, we must download it as HDR, not EXR. Otherwise, Unreal Engine won't recognize it as a cube map that we need. And the second thing, you see, I downloaded it in the 8K resolution, because the 16 key will crash my video card when I try importing it into Unreal Engine. My video card is RTX 3080 with 10GB of video memory, so depending on your video card specifications, you may want to download it in another resolution. You can download 8K for now as well, but just in case your Unreal Engine will crash during the next step, you can download and try with a less resolution. So, we download the file. Let's save it in a folder named Cinematics Tutorial Downloads. Now, open the content drawer. And under the content folder, create a new folder. Let's name it Backdrop. Right-click on empty space and select the Import option on the top of the menu. Find the file that we have just downloaded. And import it. Let's save all. Now select the imported backdrop and click on our HDRI backdrop actor in the world outliner. In the details tab near the cube map, click that little arrow and it replaces the existing backdrop with a new one. It looks a little bit too bright. Let's set the intensity to 0.3. Let's also change the size to 50. It will look better after we set up our camera, so we will see both the trees and the sky in the frame without making the lens angle too wide. And let's change the lighting distance factor to 1.76. It changes how the lighting from the picture affects the ground. You can play with its value to see the difference. Let's zoom out with our mouse wheel to see our dome from outside. And we see it has been placed somehow randomly. We want to align it with our floor, because we'll apply a quicksil material to the floor in the next episode. as it is going to become the base for our ground. So here at the top of the details tab, under the HDRI backdrop, select its child scene component. And near the location, press the restore button. And it restores all the positions to zero. But let's set the Z axis to -190, as we want the floor to settle down inside the dome at the very bottom. Alright. Now, we are going to create a post-process volume. Press the Quick Add and under the volume select the post-process volume. In many cases, we want to apply the only one post-process volume to the whole level. In this case, we select it in the scene. And in the details set this infinite extent unbound option. Thus we make the volume affect the entire level, no matter what the actual location and the size of the volume is. But sometimes we may have several different post-process volumes in one level. For example, we may have a cave and an outside terrain and a house and all in one level, and we want different lighting effects inside each of these locations. And then we add several post-process volumes to our scene and we place and scale them so each of them covers the location it is intended to affect. So, just to practice, let's do this very easy thing and scale our post-process volume so it covers our location of interest, I mean our dome, because our entire scene will be placed inside it. We select our post-process volume. And in the details tab, we scale it up and change its location so it houses our entire dome. No need to be very precise in this case. Alright, let's check it from the other side. It looks good. And we are now going to do the main thing with the post-process volume. We will do it almost every time when creating cinematics. We are going to disable the automatic exposure compensation. So, with the post-process volume selected, we go to its details tab and under the exposure section, we check the metering mode and leave it as auto. And we check the exposure compensation and set it to 0.5. But do remember, we have already reduced the intensity of our HDRI sky dome to make the scene darker, but our scene is bright again. It is because the Unreal Engine has automatically adjusted the exposure and it looks like a daylight again. And to avoid that, we need to manually set both the min brightness and the max brightness to the value of 1. By the way, the min and max brightness may be named min and max EV depending on your project. This is actually the same, so don't get confused. And now the Unreal Engine will stop adjusting the exposure inside the post-process volume. So we have the absolute control over brightness of the scene. If you want to make the scene brighter, we will either add lights or manually raise the exposure compensation. Alright, it looks good. So, we are going to break here and in the next video we will import some quick sale content to make this scene more realistic and we will import the stones and the skull. And we will possibly start working with the camera and sequencer, because we need a camera when arranging the scene, so we can look through the camera view and understand what are we going to get as the final result. And that's it for today. See you next time.